Welcome to the Seniors Rock Show, presented by the Law Office of Michael Robinson, PC, on News Radio, Wham 1180. The Seniors Rock Show, a lively weekly discussion, shining a bright light on aging with fun, entertainment, and important info for all adults. Join in with your comments or questions. Call or text 222-1180 or 1-800-295-1180. Now, from the News Radio Wham 1180 studio in downtown Rochester, here's your host, Joanna Palvino.
Welcome to Seniors Rock Radio. Glad you're here with us today. I'm here with attorney Mike Robinson and our producer Pam, who's downtown in the studio up in the tower there. So we're glad you're all here with us, and we're getting ready now for an interesting and very thought-provoking hour ahead. And we're going to start with number 7 in Mike's series on the basics of estate planning. And that's been really interesting. We're getting some great feedback, so I'm looking forward to that. Then we'll get some advice from someone who's got a lot of experience in a sometimes very uncomfortable topic. It's uncomfortable for me anyway. But Courtney Trawitz from Pets at Peace by Harris Funeral Home is here to help us understand the options we have when a beloved pet passes. I was telling Mike this morning that I'm on my own with the pets, so hopefully we won't hear them during the show. But I do have 2 dogs, and I'm a big pet lover. So I hate to think about it myself, but I want to be prepared, just like we are with our own estate plans, to do what I need to do and be educated. So I hope this subject helps the many listeners we have with pets. And I know Pam has a dog too. Then today we'll also explore age bias and how to end it. I love this subject. So does Mike. It's so in line with what we do on the show. And that's what our show's all about. You know, aging with grace and having some fun while we're doing it. Changing those old stereotypes. To quote Dr. Tracy Gendron, everything you know about aging is wrong. It's not your fault. Everything you've been taught about aging is wrong. Ageism has severe and damaging consequences to our health and happiness throughout our entire lives. So Lifespan is supporting a symposium featuring Dr. Gendron right here in Rochester. And today we've got Anne-Marie Cook here from Lifespan. She's going to tell us all about how to register to attend this free event. I've already done it, so I hope you will too. And right now we're going to turn to attorney Mike Robinson for his weekly lesson for all of us about the basics. Again, I can't say that. Basics of estate planning. I believe we're going on to number 7. Is that right, Mike? Take it away.
Hey, happy Saturday, Joanna. I think it is number 7, actually. And we're talking a little bit right before the show, our first broadcast of the autumn season. And feels a little bit like autumn out there today.
That's right. Boom, we're in fall.
Yeah. But yeah, we're going to keep going with our basics of estate planning. And, you know, as you and I have talked about many times, one of the fun things for us in doing this radio show is that every week we run into one or more persons who tell us how much they enjoy the show and appreciate the information we provide. And since we started doing the Basics of Estate Planning series back in August, I've had a number of people tell me that they're learning a lot and rethinking how they've approached their estate planning. So I thought it would be important this week to pause just a bit and review why we're doing this series on the basics of estate planning. As you know, one of our firm's core values is education. We believe it's vitally important for people to understand what are the legal processes that come into play when you become incapacitated and when you die, to understand the tools and strategies available to address those issues, and to understand how those tools and strategies are actually going to work during incapacity and at death. Because without that understanding, it's impossible to put in place an estate plan that's going to best serve you and your family. So, for example, a few episodes ago, we looked at the fact that many people rely on a will for their estate planning, thinking that their will avoid probate, when in fact, as we learned, a will requires probate in order to be implemented. And it never ceases to amaze me when I meet with folks who have current wills, and they are astounded to learn that a will requires probate, and they tell me that no one ever explained to them what will be required to implement their will when they die. You know, if I go to a restaurant and I order a cheeseburger and onion rings, my server isn't going to ask me whether that order aligns with my diet and lifestyle goals, which is fine. That's not their job. But too often, attorneys, especially those who don't concentrate their practice in estate planning, act in the same way. Someone comes in, they say, you know, I want to make a will. And the attorney just asks, okay, what do you want your will to say? You know, imagine walking into a doctor's office and saying, I want an antibiotic. And the doctor just asks, well, what kind of antibiotic would you like? Without asking about why do you want the antibiotic? What are your symptoms? And without explaining what an antibiotic can and can't do, so that together you can determine whether an antibiotic really is what you need to address your problem. So same applies in estate planning. There is a reason that we are called attorneys and counselors at law. We should be counseling our clients and not merely acting as order takers, and education is an essential part of that counseling. So, you know, Joanna, that's why I want to get this information out there to our listeners, to give our listeners an understanding of the different issues that need to be addressed with their estate plan, to give our listeners an understanding of the tools and strategies available to them, to give our listeners an understanding of how those tools and strategies really work, and thereby to put our listeners in a position to make the best decisions for themselves and for their families. So that's why we're doing this and taking the time each week to really focus on some basics. And in next week's episode, we'll pick back up and we're going to look at some additional strategies to avoid probate. As we've talked about in previous episodes, probate can be problematic, and there's a reason people do want to avoid it. So we'll take a look at some more strategies that people may choose to use. And we'll look, of course, at the relative advantages and disadvantages of those strategies.
Excellent. I have learned so much. Again, I keep thinking I've got it all down, and then you bring something new to the table. And I know that this stuff, you know, wills and estate plans, the laws change and, you know, people's lives change constantly. So it's something to be revisited, even if you think you know it all, which I know I don't. Mike, thank you for your education. And I'm so happy that your firm's core value, one of the biggest ones, is education. And folks, at mrobinsonlaw.com, you can see all kinds of info there. There's lots. If you'd like to be educated about this and you're shy about going to a webinar or to call right away, go to the website, mrobinsonlaw.com, and you're going to see a lot of really good info and a lot of, the experience that Mike has to make you comfortable to contact him. Or you can go to the next webinar, which is on September 28th. That's this coming Wednesday, believe it or not. And that's Mike's next estate planning webinar. It's 90 minutes. It's free. Check it out at mrobinsonlaw.com. You just have to register, or you can call if you don't want to do it online, 585-374-5210. So Mike, thanks again for all you do and, you know, for preparing these things every week for us. We're looking at doing a podcast, folks. So I think that'll be exciting too. And Mike can really reach out even further than this show, with a podcast that, continue this series, but we'll keep you posted on that. So one of the things I wanted to say, I've been getting educated, Mike, is about my own health, and I'm really excited about it. I am a member of Athena Direct Primary Care and Lifestyle Medicine, and if you are feeling hurt, if you are feeling that you're not being heard by your primary care physician, you definitely want to check this out because it's a very different experience, this direct primary care, and it does make a difference. It has for me. It's very convenient. And the really crazy thing is that you have direct access to your own personal physician. So mine is Laura Petrescu. She started this practice and she is actually doing a free meet and greet for new patients. She's taking new patients for limited time. So if you would like to enjoy, like I am, same day or next day appointments with your doctor, unlimited office visits, affordable pricing. It is about the same as amount as going out for dinner at this point per month. And you get a lot of really special attention, longer visits. And you can contact her. You know, you get a direct cell phone number. That's what I'm going to tell you to call your own physician. And you get whole person care because that lifestyle medicine is included in the primary care. So I can't say enough about it. Call 662-5510 if you're interested. And again, it's 585-662-5510 for Athena Direct Primary Care and Lifestyle Medicine or athenadirectcare.com. Fantastic stuff. So I hope you'll check that out. Mike, what else is coming up at the law firm?
You know, we're just we're looking at continue to look at additional ways to reach out and get information to folks. And as you mentioned, the podcast that we're working on is going to be, I think, another way for us to get some important information out to people.
All right. We'll look forward to that. We're going to tell you guys more. But you're listening now to the Seniors Rock Radio Show if you just tuned in. And we will be right back with ways to prep for that dreaded day when your pet crosses the Rainbow Bridge. Pets at Peace by Harris Funeral Home next, right here on News Radio WHAM 1180.
Skin the goat.
My, oh, my. Welcome back to Seniors Rock Radio. And we're joined right now by our guest, Courtney Trawitz. Courtney's the head pet care coordinator at Pets at Peace by Harris Funeral Home. At Pets at Peace, their philosophy is simple. Treat every pet with the same level of care and compassion that they've done since 1946 at the Harris Funeral Home. Besides caring for families and their pets, Courtney enjoys hiking with her beloved dog, Miles, along with reading, cooking, traveling, and spending time with family and friends. Thanks for joining us, Courtney.
Hey, thanks so much, and happy Saturday. Happy to be here with y'all.
Thanks, Courtney. Thanks for being with us. And you were here before, and you give us really great information. And today we're touching on a subject that nobody really wants to talk about, but we need to. So I would like to ask you the first question, and that is, when a pet dies, no matter where they are, if they're at home or at a vet's, what are the options or the steps that we might take? I haven't really thought through that process. I really need to know.
Sure, and that's a hard topic to touch on for any, you know, family member. No one really wants to think about it, but certainly good to have those thoughts run through your head. So, you know, there's a variety of ways that, a loved one can really come into our care, speaking specifically for Pets at Peace. And it really comes down to what the family is most comfortable with. So at Pets at Peace, we're available 24 hours a day. So even if a pet passes, you know, at home in the middle of the night, we are available to help. And that could be a family scheduling, you know, a time to come to us directly at our facility in Irondequoit. We can come to their home. Or if a pet passes at an animal hospital, you know, we will pick up their loved one from any animal hospital, even if we're not affiliated with them. So currently we are affiliated with 22 animal hospitals in and around Monroe County. And if, you know, a pet does pass at one of them, they're already equipped with, you know, everything that we provide. So the tracking disc that we talked about a couple weeks ago, our paperwork and our software system, which actually notifies our team when a loved one is, you know, ready to be brought into our care. So, you know, really what I like to remind families of, they have a choice. So even if they use an animal hospital that's not directly affiliated with us, they always have a choice. So they can reach out to us directly. And that's what I always suggest. Just reach out to us and we're here to help. And from there, we'll make all the arrangements to bring their loved one into our care.
Courtney, how long does it take to return a pet back home to their family at Pets at Peace, for example?
Sure. So that's a great question. So we actually have a 3 business day guarantee. So we realize that as families are sort of navigating that grieving process, it's really important to get their loved one back home with them so they can continue to move forward it in a fluid manner. So once a pet comes into our care, within those 3 business days, we will have their cremated remains available to the family. And then from there, you know, that may be us returning their pet's urn back to the animal hospital if the family's most comfortable with that. Or if they prefer to come to our funeral home, we're actually open 6 days a week. So we can schedule a time that's most convenient and comfortable for the family to come to us and get their loved one back home. So, bring a little bit of comfort back to the family.
Very nice. You are very accommodating, obviously, and that 24/7, being available, Courtney, over there at Pets at Peace. That makes me feel really comfortable because I worry, you know, what happens? I don't know. So thank you for explaining that and for being there for everybody. Just like you are with Harris Funeral Home and have been for years and years. And I know that Rick and family have had a lot of speakers in over the years, too. So let's go back to the pets, though. I have a question. If your pet is going to a vet that you're not affiliated with, can we request you? Is that something you can just tell your vet, well, if something happens, I want you to do this? Can you set that up ahead of time?
Oh, absolutely. So we actually implemented a pre-planning portal on our website. Probably about a year and a half or so ago. And again, like you touched on, it's not something you really want to think about, think about losing a loved one. But it's an important thing to consider, what are your wishes when it comes to that point, when it's time to take the next step. And, if a pet passes and it's sudden and you haven't really pre-planned for it or thought about it, there's a lot happening in that moment. So we have the pre-planned portal where families can take all the time they need. It's very simple, a handful of steps that move you through that process, and it really provides all of your wishes for how you'd like to move forward when your pet does pass. And from there, a family would just reach out to us, and we'd have everything, in our system. And from there, we'd make all the arrangements for the family, so it's one less thing that they really need to worry about.
Excellent. Courtney, you make me feel a lot more comfortable about this. Thank you for your very loving way to support families. Folks, Courtney, thank you for being here. We'll have you back again. Say hi to Rick. And Pets at Peace treats pets that have passed with care and compassion, folks. They are the gold standard in the industry. Think about the options available. Get a plan down. Courtney at Pets at Peace can help you if you want to call them, or you can go to Harris Funeral Home or Pets at Peace online. So thank you again, Courtney. This is the Seniors Rock Radio Show. So if you want to help us fight ageism, stay right there because we're going to talk about that next on News Radio WHAM 1180.
The Law Office of Michael Robinson, PC, has helped families protect their hard-earned wealth from nursing home expense, probate, and taxes. Visit us online to register for our free educational webinar to learn how you can protect you and your family. mrobinsonlaw.com.
When you've lost movement, flexibility, strength, or balance, traveling a long distance for physical therapy seems like a bad decision. That's why Agape Physical Therapy has a convenient location near you, east side or west side. And there's a new location in Pittsburgh with Aqua Therapy. Let Agape Physical Therapy and wellness professionals customize a treatment program for you to help you recover quickly. Visit agapephysicaltherapy.com and schedule your free consultation today. No doctor referral needed.
Summer's ends around the bend, just flying. The swimming suits are on the line, just
welcome back to Seniors Rock Radio. This is Joanna, your host. I'm here with Mike Robinson, attorney Mike Robinson. He's my co-host and Pam, our producer. And we're thinking about some serious things today, and I want to talk about ageism now. The formal definition of ageism is discrimination and stereotyping on the basis of age. we're ageist anytime we behave toward a person or a group based on how old they are. So, like all isms, stereotyping is at the heart of ageism. The assumption that everyone in a group is the same is just not right. Like thinking everyone in a retirement home is the same age, or old is what they think. But in reality, we age at different rates physically, socially, and cognitively. The roots of ageism run really deep, both in history and in our own personal denial. So now we welcome Anne Marie Cook from Lifespan, who's here to tell us about an opportunity to learn more about combating ageism and about the crippling effect that it has, the myths, the stereotypes, all at a special free event coming soon to Rochester. I've already signed up to go, so please check it out and do so yourself so we can all work together on this. Hello, Anne Marie. Welcome to the show. Please tell the listeners more.
Oh, thank you so much, Joanna and Mike, for having me back again today. As you said, ageism is a very serious and wide-ranging problem that we have that I think, unfortunately, we don't even recognize it. And so Lifespan is very proud to bring to town Dr. Tracy Gendron, who just wrote a book, Ageism Unmasked. We'll be having this event October 13th. Think of it, Joanna, like a TED Talk, really talking about the devastating impact of ageism on older adults, but honestly, everybody in society. It's a free event, but you do need to register on Lifespan's website, so I encourage people to go and register, and I think it'll be a wonderful and also enlightening event for everybody who chooses to attend.
Yeah, that sounds great. I know I'm looking forward to attending, and it is great to bring Anne Marie this issue to the fore because, you know, those of us who work with seniors primarily, we see this happening every day, and you do see how it impacts our elders and in terms of their own self-image. You know, how do they feel useful in society? And so often ageism, as Joanna said, as with so many isms, happens without us even knowing.
Yep, exactly. And it just arrives one day, I think, sometimes, and you feel bad about it and you start wondering about it. I don't know when it happened to me, but Anne Marie, I think you probably know what I'm talking about. You get to a certain point and you're thinking, I feel a little invisible, or wow, when did my neck start looking like that? But, you know, there's lots of ways to get around this. And I think if we all work together, young and old, because there's that reverse ageism as well, right?
No, absolutely. And Joanna, you're so right. And, you know, I think what people don't recognize is it isn't funny, because really there's a lot of research that shows that ageism is associated with poor physical and mental health, increased isolation and loneliness, greater financial insecurity, believe it or not, because of really age discrimination in the workforce, and really a decreased quality of life, and even premature death. And this is such a serious issue worldwide that for the first year ever, the World Health Organization is designating October 7th as Ageism Awareness Day, really trying to get out around the world that discriminating people based on their age is detrimental not only to the person, but society in general. So on October 13th, like I said, we'll have this wonderful talk about ageism unmasked and really what we can do to ensure that we're not discriminating against people based on their age.
Terrific. It's such an important topic. And, you know, we do it to ourselves. I've mentioned this before. I do it to myself all the time. And I think bringing this to light, and I think it's happening all over the country, hopefully the world, that, you know, we're changing things, because I think over the years, I mean, there was a time when elders were respected, when older adults were respected. And it seems that we have become the brunt of jokes on commercials and some other things. So I think we got to bring this back to reality, like you said, Anne Marie Cook, and, you know, remind people it's not funny. And these things are very hurtful. And if you're feeling like that, you're feeling invisible. I've had my own friends say that, you know, that one day they felt invisible. You know, talk to someone. Reach out. We're here. We're all doing this together, and that's what the show's about. So come back every Saturday. I'll put a little plug in there, too. But Dr. Rocco Vivenzio, the Memorial Symposium is Thursday, October 13th. It's from 5:30 till 7:00. and it's at the Eisenhart Auditorium at Rochester's Museum and Science Center. And what are you planning there? What's lifespan? Are they going to have you know, a representation there, or a table or anything, Anne-Marie, folks can look for?
We sure will, Joanna. We'll have our brochures out so people know more about lifespan. Certainly a small reception before the actual TED Talk occurs, but also a time in which all of us will be able to participate in the conversation about ageism, the negative impacts, and I think what we all can do to make sure it doesn't continue.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, the stories, I mean, think about it. Think about what you do to yourself. And you know, I mentioned before, I told Mike a story once around the air about I was driving by a big truck one time in the rain, and in my head, all of a sudden pops in, oh, you're driving like an old lady. And I thought, no, I'm not. I'm driving safely. I had to correct myself. So it's not, you know.
But you are right.
For bringing this to Rochester. And again, it's Dr. Tracy Gendron, author of Ageism Unmasked, Exploring Age Bias and How to End It in Lifespan. And you, Anne-Marie Cook, are amazing for bringing all of these programs and all of the things you do to us and to our listeners. So thank you again.
Thank you so much. Have a great day.
You too. Have a great
week. Thanks, Anne-Marie.
The Law Office of Michael Robinson, PC, has helped families protect their hard-earned wealth from nursing home expense, probate, and taxes. Visit us online to register for our free educational webinar to learn how you can protect you and your family. mrobinsonlaw.com.
Autumn in New York. Why does it seem so inviting?
Well, there you go. Autumn in New York. So our music bumps today have been acknowledging the end of summer and the beginning of autumn. And as with every autumn, Naples, my former hometown, is hosting the annual Naples Grape Festival. So I want to give a shout out. What a great day to show off Naples. It's a pretty town, and on a day like today, it's a great place to be.
And grape pie is so good. I already had some this week. Somebody in my family went down there last week to beat the crowd, brought some home. So I have had a little slice or two, and it's fantastic. So, yeah, Naples, New York, what a beautiful spot to go to. And,
yeah,
and enjoy. And what else you got going on?
Well,
big Bills weekend.
Yeah, this is one of 2 weeks a year that Bills fans don't really care whether their tuna is dolphin safe or not. So so we're going to look forward to a good game, hopefully tomorrow.
Good. Yeah. Go Bills. Right. And I'd like to remind everyone to, you know, go to our sponsors, support them like they support us. Thank you, Mike, and the Law Office of Michael Robinson, PC, for being our presenting sponsor. And to all our supporting sponsors, including Lifespan and all the other folks that you hear during the show. And if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be here every week, every Saturday from noon till one. So thank you there. And this educational piece that we bring to the air is really something, I think, and I'm really proud of the fact that we bring all these different things that help folks, especially aging adults, but also families of aging adults and the professionals that work with them, because we all need to work together. And today we talked about ageism, learned about that, and we'll learn more on October 13th at that symposium. And again, that's at Lifespan if you want to register. We learned about pets and what to do at that very crucial time when we want to grieve and we've lost a pet. And, you know, having that plan in place is just like with Mike and the estate planning and your will. It's, you know, you'll be glad you did it when the time comes. It's not something you want to think about, obviously, but you will be glad you did it.
That's so true. You know, we talk about with our clients the importance of pre-planning just to save their family the aggravation and the stress of of having to do all that planning when they've just lost someone. And the same does apply to pets. And I think about it. I mean, I've in my adult life have had to say goodbye to at least three. And it's not fun to have to scramble around with all the practical stuff at that time.
No, you need to be banding together and supporting each other and you know, and just maybe celebrating in memories and things like that. You know, just like we do when, you know, a person passes, because it is, they're part of our family. So thanks again to Pets at Peace and Courtney for helping us through that. And she's there anytime anyone needs some help and any direction. So don't forget about them. And also don't forget that Mike's webinar is this Wednesday at 2:00, and you can register at mrobinsonlaw.com. So lots going on. Naples webinar. October. So we hope you enjoyed this week's show, and that till we meet again in October, that you'll keep moving and smiling. And if you get down to Naples, having some pie, enjoy yourself. That's what it's all about. Right, Mike?
Absolutely. And I can't believe that it's October is our next show, just a week away. Crazy.
I know. So, folks, it is going to be the fall. So send that message that we're all sticking together